back here for the semi-finals for the World of War Test tournament to see Chino from USA up against Todesser, the man from Russia, as USA. This has gone a regular squad, and Chino has gone assault squad, I think. Yep. No, he's gone a regular squad, sending most down the roadway, and Todesser sending most to the wall. And looks like an interesting movement from Chino. He's going to come down to the left to center. Todesser has split his troops out quite well, as is per usual. Chino won't get an easy flank from this area. So, Southern Point is going to go strongly to Chino. And a few guys on the right for Chino are going to try sneaky cap this area perhaps. Use this housing area to throw a grenade and stop the cap as well. Lost one guy. And Todesser caps Northern Point without any opposition. So Italy, second time we've seen this nation. First time with Hansi and Panzer. One of the nations not too favoured by most. It's probably the least worked on to my in World at War, to be honest. It's one of the nations that hasn't been given a good look at. Though it is pretty decent in my opinion. It does have good units. Just doesn't have, I suppose, the standard super units. So some nations do have like units that you can rely upon. Italy has a lot of good situational units which you can use to combine to do good things, but yeah, that's the thing. It's quite hard to do sometimes, relying on super tank destroyers, special units, etc. 18 infantry from Todesser? Interesting buy. He probably was expecting that to be something else. As Chino tries to run over the cover, I think his purpose was to just go over the cover, take out the stone walls, and do it. So this is the Chino's last chance in the tournament. He lost the first one to Todesser in, I wouldn't say a super close game, I would say a game full of potential for Chino. Chino could have won that many times, in my opinion. It was just not taken advantage of. Assault squad from Chino, second by. Regular squad from Todesser, now going to go to the southern. We're on winter fields once again. The map is winter fields. Been actually one of the most favoured maps in the tournament to choose for some reason. It's a default map. It's full of action. It's quite flat. There's a few interesting areas that, quite plain. It's still loved by the players, so I don't know if they're loved. Maybe it's chosen strategically instead of for liking. It's chosen to win, I don't know. 44.7 cannon. That's the 80 gun of Italians, the best light 80 gun in the game. Todesser, getting away. So hopefully Chino can pull out some magic this time. Like the other game, I guess, but this time not throw away the potential win that he had. Salt squad, no, 30 cal. 30 cal squad. Chino with a veteran sniper. Commando sniper. I might change to the Italians because you know USA units and it might be more interesting to see what options Chino has. Going to the assault squad. He's got the numbers now. That's one thing that he'll have on USA regulars. USA regulars forming a line. The sniper is great in a shootout and will be able to turn the tide in this end. Though Todesser is planning to do some counter sniping, it seems, so gonna probably go straight for this. Let's see how successful he is. He's definitely on it. Look at it. Oh, he's taking out counter snipe. Bam, veteran sniper counter snipe by that bugger. In the latest patch, there is this was played before the latest patch, so there is no limits to snipers. So Chino can buy as many veteran snipers as he likes, which is the strategy Mr. Pringles uses with this nation, spamming the Skumbuski infantry and the commando snipers with carabinieri. I don't know if I said it right. Carbonara. It's a form of pasta and also a special unit in the World at War mod. Let's see what's happening. Got that, what the hell? What did he buy that? What is that? I can't remember. It's just an MG, but where is it in the actual menu tree? It's the auto blinder 40, that's alright. It's a 150 MP. It's just got a few MDs. Not that great. Very cheap though. I wouldn't buy it in this situation. He's got the flame tank, could have been his option. 160 MP, it's a very cheap flame tank for Italy. Could clean the center, but AP sniping with the light 80 gun. Probably one of the worst ones to AP snap with due to its power and less accuracy. Not really needed to have power. But actually, he's doing well, so don't mind me. Sniper, picking away, and it's funny that USA is actually winning because of the sniper when they don't even have a special sniper. Can shoot over the wall, it seems. And here's a, is that another sniper? No, it's still the AP sniping. Though I dare say this a light 80 gun is actually doing more worth than the sniper at the other end. It's killing so many guys quite quickly. Suppose this map is good for it, especially because it's Stonewall versus Stonewall. And the Carabiniere is out. These guys are great for vision. They can see a bit further and spot stealthy units better, but they don't have great combat skills. So yeah, that's a decent at that, and well, I'm just impressed that this 4.7 cannon, it's got 8. Okay, it's not that bad, not that much. But it's racking it up. Almost making it some money's worth. Probably has if it killed an MG. Still nothing going to Todesser. Oh, it's a Todesser? Wow, I didn't realize this. Todesser's actually totally overwhelmed the northern point of the map. We've got MGs below this hill, as you can see. It's one of the things about infantry combat. Camping below hills is great in AS2. And this prevents Chino from going up this hill. As he goes up, he's going to get shot up before even returning fire or even seeing the enemy. Chino relocating some of his carabineros to the right to fill in the gaps. Moving his light conundrum. Quite interesting to see that the map's kind of locked down on the side. It usually turns out to be a one-sided game on this map because wipes are quite easy due to the proximity of proximity between the flags, and also there being not so much cover to defend. You can quite easily rape the guy to spawn. But wow, how many kills has this bastard got? 13 kills, racking it up and even taking out Marines now. And Todesser is refusing to acknowledge its worth, as it's not buying a counter like an M8 or anything of the sort. It's just going to let it do its business and be content with holding the two flags, I'm guessing. 16-0, he's happy to just beat Todesser. Just put units all over the map. Space out his inventory everywhere and just take the hits. He's just gonna wait till the croc comes out maybe to take it out. He's got time, I guess. The three-pointers are nearly almost out. 1 minute, actually. Wonder how this is gonna play out. You can see, just like, I've never actually played this map in a tournament, because this is the first time I've been in a tournament, because I thought it'd be cool to just see. I'm gonna take a vote later on in after the tournament on what maps to keep for the next one. The next one's probably a 2v2 tournament. But this is the actual area I use for my infantry tutorial. It's pretty cool that actually someone's doing the exact same thing I did in my tutorial. And that being Todesser. I'm sure he didn't watch my tutorial and think that. He just knows how to do it. Here he is, wow. Okay, here's the Adria Corps. The elite, I guess you can call them like the LRDG squad or SAS of the Italians. Their use of paratroopers, but also they were known for their raids in jeeps. They've got stealth too. Interesting fact, you should probably right click on these two guys. They drop off and then you can sneak them around. And W won't be wasted. Oh, nearly nasty. What killed it? Ah, okay, is it 20mm out? The cannon, 20mm Scotty. And with the 4.7 inch together. Take a look at this. The two good emplacements together, but I guess the problem now is for Chino is that croc. It should have been expected, but he doesn't have anything that can take it out. Look at the CP though of the Italians, doing very well. That's one of the other benefits. They got low CP vehicles, units. There goes that truck. What is he going to get to counter? Nothing, he's got another Carabinieri squad. Interesting. Tank Hunter, probably not, especially since, yeah, Pack 40s don't do well versus Crocs, to be honest. Oh, wow, he's got a sim event. Sorry, guys, I just can't help talking like that when I'm trying to discover Italian things. Sim event. Coming in. This is like a G-gun, to be honest. Not sure about this one. It can't withstand it. Probably should have gone the one above it. It's got the... it's got this one. Did he get the... Wow! The croc has got killed by the sim event at 72-32. Which one is that? 75-32. Oh, he did buy the... No, he did hold this one. It's the G1. Yeah, he did buy the G1. He's taken it out at max range. Perfect for 360 MP. That's cheap, hey, for what it can do. Did a fantastic job. It's great to see Italians work somehow. And I think they work even better with recon because you can actually see things, and tech destroyers are good. Are good for that. The problem is they can't see. The enemy can spot. You can spot the tank. The tank destroyer can plan to approach it. I guess on this map it's kind of perfect for tank destroyers to being pretty narrow. And also, CP in the mod, you can see the tank destroyer's CP. They're pretty much nothing. You can have it sit back in the field so it doesn't actually take up your army's worth. So you can use it as a tank destroyer. Wait for the ambush. You don't have to make it in the open doing other things. Sniper? Shut up, Italian. Seriously, it's just talking. The voice actor here. It's kind of annoying, isn't it? I think I've heard that they say a lot of swear words. Signore. I think, they say really bad things, apparently, according to some people who speak Italian. Needs to counter things, so what can he get? The M8, maybe? Even the M8 might be good, to be honest. It's actually better in the mod, a bit more accurate. M1 AT gun, interesting. There's not too much... I guess he can take out the Panzer III. Oh, he's gone! The Africa Corps! And this is gonna be a kick in the balls for Todesser if... played right. 80. And once taken out the P3, now the P3F. It's a P3J. P3F using the J as a cover and can potentially take out the M180 gun. Let's take a look. Don't mind that lag, it's fixed in the next patch. Oh, hull damage to the P3. And Africa Corps unfortunately lined up to that 80 infantry. This is the map of emplacement, so some sort of powerful unit can just shoot down one lane. And wow, oh, it's down. Did it get, yeah, it's main gun. No, it's not main gun. It's still it still can fire, but what actually took it out? I think the AT gun did take it out. Kananda has decrewed it once again, and potentially the AT gun can play. No, it doesn't want to play. Wants to go back into the safety. And let's have a look. Recruit squad, Julia division. So he spent, wow, Chino really spent up, hey. He spent his entire special points in 13 minutes in the game. So this is the Julian squad, the Eastern Front veterans, like the Brandenburgers, with slightly better weaponry. Slightly better. Worst MG though, I think. No, so what MG do they have? To be honest, I am not sure. And that will make, that will depend, I guess, if I would say they're bad or not. Have they got the MG34, have they? Let me click on you. Huh. Why can I click? Oh, I selected, that's why. I can't click on selected units. Stop selecting him! Okay, finally. Okay, yeah, he's got the MG34, so it is definitely better than the Brandenburgers. To be honest, it shouldn't be. Just, yes. Try to balance Italian some way. Has taken out the AD gun for sure. Nice push from Chino, just knowing when to attack. Tank destroyer. Now Chino's kind of low on the CP, on the MP, and the CP. Has overwhelmed Todesser. Kill wise quite even so far. Semivente. Moving up a bit. You will say stuck back. I wonder if this is saving his points. Looks like he's got a bit more up his sleeve. Wow, his MP situation is dire. 56 Though he does have three specials, potentially waiting for that second croc, I'm guessing he would be. Oh, it's another M180 gun, for what? Because he really wants to take out that tank destroyer. Another croc, perhaps. Though, getting that croc, I mean, he has no infantry, and Todesser, and sorry, Chino does have a lot of MP. This doesn't look good for Todesser at all. Similar to happened in the other game, Chino manages to kill a lot more of Todesser's troops and eventually win in terms of kill counts, but not on flag counts. But I think this game's different. This game is a lot ahead in terms of kills. Money, MP, M180 gun. What is it trying to do? Gonna try maybe do the HE shell on that. Don't know. Another croc is out, I suspect it. So, needs to somehow. Oh, some Aventa has been taken out by the M180 gun. It looks so far away, does it? But it's only 110 away. Can only imagine Rob's mod. This gun will aim all the way across the map. It's a bit spastic, in my opinion. For I guess the game and the maps in this. Millimeter. Scotty moving away. Well, these emplacements have lasted the whole game. Interesting, they haven't even been fired at. Oh, sorry, they have been now, and the croc can take them both out. And it may be the unit to change everything, to be honest, because I don't know if Chino has the money to respond to the croc yet. They are quite cheap, the tank destroyers. Chino gonna try the 3-cap, pressuring, and he may. Todesser hasn't got any infantry in that area. Not sure why. It's pretty CP capped, that's why. He's got a lot of troops in the backfield here doing nothing. It's line of sight. I'm gonna change shit. I gotta delete the coughing sound for the Italian, sorry guys. It's not good to hear. Strat cough and the Italians cough at the same time, isn't it? Have a coughing competition. I wonder who coughed more, the Italian AI or me? A cough off. Panzer H. Okay, interesting. Escalation. Do have that option. Chino does have the money for it. Though, might have sent him back on their MP wise. As you can see now, Todesser has taken the lead MP, which will allow him to field more infantry than Chino. But Chino does have the units, to be honest. He has the 20 mil. He's got all the units to win this game, for sure. Croc will take back the point with the support of some conscripts. Only conscripts, wow. Sniper in jeopardy. 50 cals. Oh, 50 cal has taken. No, it hasn't. What took it out? The M1 Garand took it out. Okay. M1 Garand, nice. M180 gun positioning in the center. Panzer H. Ooh, it's definitely coughing more than me, I betcha. Probably not a week ago, though. I guess I'll give him some slack. He's dying on the battlefield. What else would you do? Coughing is perfectly fine. Actually, quite surprised, actually, in a war. Not that realistic, to be honest. There's realism mods. Come on. Gotta have some people dying, screaming, calling for their mama. Things like that. You don't hear them. You don't hear people scream and cry in this mod. Or in mods in general. So, gotta get away from the Italian voices. Gotta go on this end. Sorry, not Italians in general, just the voice acting here. Just coughing into my ear. Not very pleasant, my friend. Croc in a nice position from the Dessa. I can reign over this area, take out those two emplacements. The H is going to start to approach. Oh, it's cracked. Got a shot, and this will allow the H to just keep peppering away at that croc non-stop until it hits. It's going to be hard to kill, as the croc is at maximum range, but eventually you'll get a lucky shot off hitting the unsloped part of the croc, and we'll potentially take it out. Let's see. Oh, doesn't matter. It's taking it out. Straight up. Oh. It just hit right there where the flame is. Finito! Conscripts going to the southern point. M180 gun moving away. Scotty. Wow. Chino can just come in now to the center. I think that Scotty's being a little bit safe. Oh, finally, as I said that, it's moving. Potentially even go down this little ditch. Be so hard to hit. M180 gun repositioning. Todesser is in trouble right now. And I guess really hasn't been... Maybe he's the counter to Pringles, to be honest. I don't know. Is he going to be great at 1v1s versus everyone? Like, he's obviously great, but maybe he's a specific type of player to beat Pringles. There are players like that. Like, you do... Some players can beat other players, and that player that was beaten. I can't explain it. What's going on in my mind? Some players can beat other players, but can't beat anyone else. But that player that got beaten can beat the players that the other player beat. I don't know if that makes sense. It's just the style. Like I don't know. Sorry, guys. I just don't know what I'm talking about. I am tired. M1 mortar. Wow. And what actually decrewed that? Must have been the H. Interesting. How did that happen? I don't not know. M180 gun trying to HE shell that 20mm. But mortar. It's a little ditch, I guess. It's going to be relatively... Hopefully it's... Hopefully safe. It's a bigger ditch right there. Mortar over here will be safe for sure, but won't have rain in the center. Going to try and get a bit closer just behind that ditch, I'm guessing. Maybe not ditch, I guess you can call it decline. And take the placements out. Very nice buy, I think, from Todesser. And the placement rain is over. Though, the range of this mortar, how far is this mortar from everything? See, I can't... So just around here. So it has rain. It's already decrewed the AT gun and we'll take it out eventually. There it goes. Nice mortar play. This is great to see the pool of units being exhausted. The options for the boat place. Taking out the 20mm Scotty. I love it. Brilliant choice there from Todesser. None of these choices would be available in the mod because they're shit. Not in the mod, sorry, in default. Because they're crap in default. And now you can see the beauty of the mod showing that there is counters. Counters work, and there's many counters. Opens up the strategic possibilities that Todesser has to come back into this game. He's digging deep right now. Digging a mortar out of his ass to take out those 20 mils. Replacements, and that H now is, just relegated to just sitting there. Now, Chino needs, look at his MP. He's got stacks, man. He should definitely escalate this to something. The mortar's out, so I guess the sniper will be a little bit risky. The placement will be risky. Definitely go an in plate. Even a flamethrower, or flame tank, or you can go, what's this bugger? This bastard. Right here, the 20mm, auto blind at 41, 20mm. Or the Fiat Ansalado. Can both do the job without getting mortared and taking him to behind cover. As MP is not a problem Chino has. Oh, he's got his own mortar. That's just that's not taking. It's the Brixia mortar, which does have a faster fire rate. Slightly less damage though, and it's actually doing okay, to be honest. Decent buy. Its range is a bit less as well than the other. It's a lighter mortar. It's doing okay, I guess. Definitely 20mm would have been a lot better, in my opinion, to just take advantage of the situation that Todesser has. His MP isn't too bad either. To be honest, Todesser has enough MP for a counter for that 20mm too, though that H will just have something to say to that as soon as it comes. Vida Papia, shut up. Sorry, anyone who's watching is Italian. I just don't like that voice actor. The volume of his voice is a bit weird. I don't know. it's not me. I like the Italian language. I love watching Eurovision, guys. I don't know if I guess Europe people will probably think I'm like uncool, you know, or those dorky people that watch Eurovision. Everyone in Europe thinks it's stupid. No, I guess they don't. It's quite popular, I think, isn't it? I think it's cool. I like watching different cultures and different type of songs. I hate pop songs, but I guess Eurovision these days are turning out to be a pop fest, isn't it? The last few years it's been generic pop songs written by composers that write pop songs. Anyway, just talking nonsense. That 20 mil auto blinder 41 unfortunately ran a bit too risky without any sort of opposition. This gets taken out. Any sort of line of sight, I mean, could have just sat on this flag with the H big brother to protect it and would have wiped out the entire center point. Go Malta, peppering away at each other. Oh, interesting. This is a goodbye, Chino. Yes, yes, yes. This gun can. It's like the howitzer of the Italians. 75mm can take out this, like a Panzer N. In a dodgy truck. Come on, take out these emplacements. They do have the options for this. One of the unique things though, you don't want to fire this above the crew as it kills the crew for some reason. Don't ask me why. I haven't tried to fix it. I just ported the model. And I think, why not? It's just, it's your fault for not knowing. It's like part of the game knowledge. The noise, yeah, I guess, maybe the fire, I don't know how that works. But now, it's okay. It's part of the Italian design. The Malta connect, oh, actually, not a great buy because cars are susceptible to HE rounds and mortars can, if a mortar shell lands close to the end, then it's going to go boom. Todesser's locking down the center point with not much, I guess, with no tank, with no emplacement, oh, except that mortar. This is very different. M1 trying to get a closer shot. Chino does notice, moving away, gonna try return the favor, misses. Wow. M1 misses as well, let's see. Oh, M1's been decrewed and so has that mortar sandbag. It's only got one crew on it too, so it can't run away. M1 is down for good. And also the M1 mortar and the M1AD gun down at the same time. 75mm autocannon in that, what truck is that? I don't know, some sort of Fiat. Taking out that. And that. This is turning to be a freaking epic game on this map. This map is so flat to spawn. Look, bam. Look how flat it is and how... How isn't it now someone's not locking down someone's spawn, is the question. And interesting to know, to see that. Now a lot of firepower from the Italians now, Mortar, Arty, and SPG, Panzer H, and Todesser still holding on with just infantry spread out. Your mortars are very attritional, they don't really do explosive damage unless you're talking about the Japanese Type 97. Was it Type 97 or whatever number it is? The one. What is that? I can't remember. What caliber it is. Oh, so much fire. So it's destroyed itself. That's I'm putting it down to not a bug, to Italian engineering. Man, I'm insulting the Italians a lot in this cast. Sorry, guys. They're great. I like Luigi and Mario. I play Super Mario Brothers. No, just joking, guys. I love Italian food. I don't actually have Italian friends, to be honest, but it's not that I don't want to have them. But yeah, don't worry. I will give more love to the Italian nation. I'll check out that issue there. It's not. I'm digging myself a grave right now. The Mafia is probably going to come after me. Just going to get assassinated. GG. GG, well played. Hazard is probably watching, calling his Mafia friends. Oh no, I'm digging myself an even bigger grave. Stereotyping. Okay, I'll shut up and say, I love Italians. I love spaghetti. Bolognese? Oh no. I am an idiot. Oh, shut up. Chino's doing well with the Italians, that's for sure. I'm certainly not doing well with the casting. Vixie Mortar pounding away. Chino's managed to finally get into the center point at 97 amidst the supreme firepower he had all game. Panzer 3F is being repaired. Potentially the H should be used more aggressively, coming down onto the flag point itself. Oh! Todesser! Nice flank, has taken out the Brixia 45 light mortar with a ranger. With a ranger with a panzer with a without a recoilless rifle, okay. That was an elite 80 infantry call or something. This guy is crazy. Carado Casaletelli wants to really kill this guy. Look at him. He's sadistic. Hey guys. Hey man. Okay man, go home. Go home, go home. Crazy bastard. Marino Bettolini. Lorenzo Cosensi. Enzo Baccaredi. It's like I'm drunk, guys. Sorry. I don't know why I am being an idiot right now. I apologize again to you Italian viewers. A shot right here. We'll take out those two. Panzer H. This cover spawn. Oh, nice shot, my friend. Chino, get in there. Oh, no. What's that? I thought it was 18 between. No, it's not. Sneaking in the cap in the ditches. Wow, Chino's really low on MP and infantry. He can only afford recruit squads. The H definitely needs to be aggressive, and that's what Chino's doing. But he hasn't got, oh, he's just done it. He's decapped it. Nice. Wow, that could have been game-changing. 97, he would have been game. Now Chino has a chance. He's got the recruit squad back in there. Oh, this needs to be so aggressive with this H right now. It's down to the wire. Conscripts, what the hell was that? Just hit something here and then blew up over there. And every little unit counts, and this one ranger is the boss of the field right now. Versus recruits. It's fighting farmers. Here's an elite troop. 80 infantry from Todesser. He really wants to down that H. Very expensive unit at this stage of the game. Choosing to go either a squad to help cap a flag or an 80 infantry which potentially can do nothing. Potentially fail to kill the H, but potentially kill the H. So, a risk there from Todesser. Chino really does need to get a flag to stay in the game. 33 minutes in. Can he stop this cap? Oh, what was that? Dynamite. He picked up the dynamite off of the tank. Oh no, it's not. Okay. I think it's out of HE shells. Yep, it's out of HE shells. Get your MG blazing. That's AP, he's trying to AP that too. What the hell? Oh, the Semivent is repaired. I don't know if this should be used as infantry support, but I guess if you need to, you need to. Send everything. Send your tank destroyers. Oh, Todesser with the sneaky. This guy, Faruzi Kanzanti, failed. Oh, bounced. Lucky bastard. He's trying to AP snipe it. He's got the HE shells. Running for it. Oh, bad luck to Todesser. And Chino has got a bit of a chance to come back again. He's still got the H. The H is unbelievably being very, very passive. This is just one waste. He wants to just use the Simaventa instead. So Evente is not doing much. Oh, what the hell is that? He's capping though, he's got another recruit squad and the excuse me. Panzer 3 hostess, oh my god. Another 18 infantry from Todesser. He's gonna risk it to get the biscuit. Most definitely. And that's what he's going to do. That's his plan of attack. Panzer F. And Chino wouldn't be expecting another bazooka, and this Panzer F is going to die as soon as it's been prepared. No, at least the H is alive and Chino does know the bazooka is still there. Trying to AP snipe with the H, bit of wishful thinking. Another bazooka kill coming up potentially. Yeah, very soon. Conscripts coming to the center. So Venta MG, only one star though. So I really won't do too much in my opinion. Just there. There is a shield for that Panzer H, but bazooka. Oh, misses. It's powerless to hit it. I don't think that MG can traverse very well to the sides. Oh, lucky hitting the angle. Very nice angle there. And the H has taken out the AT infantry. Oh, this is just weird. Stupido. Is that a word? I thought, Strons or whatever. That was stupid. I don't know. Idiot. Maybe that's what it means. Nice. Todesser gives me a nice explosion on the screen. It's taken out Chino's. Some event it. But still that H is on the field. Hasn't been doing much though. Not much of an impact. Chino still waiting for that timer for that 60 to get that recruit squad. To be honest, Todesser now can swarm all his men to this side too and try to take it. That MG's out of ammo. See, come on. Oh, what? That's why. He bought the bread of Safat. You see that a lot these days. MG's being bought at the last stages of the game because you know the enemy can't counter it. And it's just there to be annoying. Though, oh, that's setting back. Setting back. Is really, he needs to hold. Oh, he does! He's decruited! And this is good. The bread of Safat can go closer. Right here, in my opinion. Just to hover the flag. Because right now, it's just shooting at guys behind cover, which is a waste. It's doing okay, though. I love it. So many units in play. And even a single MG buy from Chino. Jeez, 97.25. Damn, this is going to be a long upload for me. Hanku. Capping. Ooh. What's the situation? To be honest, Todesser can swarm Chino. Just swarm him. And that's, he doesn't know because the fog of war's off, but if he knew, that's the best strategy. He can just overwhelm Chino right now. Chino, I guess his best bet is to really focus on the center. Oh no! Crashed. Miscues, you guys. You know what? I crashed, as you know. And I waited bloody 34 minutes to get to this part. There's no bloody fast forward in this replay system that we paid for in DLC. GG. Much crashes, much love for replays. This happens too often. So, hope you appreciate it, guys. I'm going to cast the rest of the match. I think it's 36 minutes where I crashed. Seeing such an epic struggle between these two players. And this is where Chino gets, this is a deja vu for me, sorry, you're probably just watching this like a few seconds ago. But bam, there he goes, and if my memory serves me, I think this guy gets tracked right now. Let's just test my memory, my old man memory, you get to witness how good my memory is at old age. This has happened about 2 hours ago, so not that bad. And I think this one bounces, I remember it bounces, it hits this. Oh no, sorry, didn't. Okay, fine. I am an old man. Unfortunately. Oh, so this is where he buys that MG. Okay, still a few, bit more to go. So what a game. I don't know exactly why Italy did really well. Look at the scores though. Vehicles to Des. Infantry-wise, to Des is up. Vehicles as well. I don't remember Chino losing 12 vehicles. I think he lost lots of emplacements. I guess they're relatively cheap. He lost a truck. I don't know, to be honest. I wonder how much MP they both used, actually. I'll see that at the end of the game. That'll be interesting to see how much payback Italy had based on their CP. Dynamite. I think this is where I left off. If I haven't, don't worry. So let's continue the cast. So Chino, in that little circle, and Todesser coming in with conscripts, tank crew doing some clutch pistol play. And some single SMGs from Todesser on hold fire. Interesting why he's got all these units on hold fire. It's a strange tactic. And really getting into those little holes. Breda. Breda Safat. Oh no. Still in the flag. Can this one guy take it back? Let's go back to Chino's view. Oh. Sprinkle to the face. Nice. Beretta has taken him out. Si. Breda 30? All the guns named Breda. I guess that's the name of... Oh, it's Beretta. Sorry, not Breda. Panzer H using the F as a little bit of a armor. Extra armor. Sorry. I remember now. This is why Chino bought that Breda, so that's why he didn't have enough money for another squad. So let's see if Todesser can take advantage of this. What's he got now? It's a full conscript squad. Ooh, it's sounds scary. Scary at this stage of the game when no one has money for any squad. It's a conscript squad. Oh no. Run away! Apologies, guys. I think I've actually recorded that part too. Yep. Actually, yeah, started the recording way too early. Never mind. Get to put up with my voice again. Boom. And H. Let's see it roll into the center, perhaps. It's a definitely get coverage. There's only conscripts. There's a sneaky, sneaky conscripts coming in. And the thing is, this could go on all day, to be honest. Imagine it just goes on non-stop, like an hour, 2 hour game. There's been 1v1s that last an hour and a bit in AS1. There was a tournament game between Short Time and Massive Worry. It's like, I'm talking history that's actual history. It's funny that I do remember that. It's, that happened about 4 years ago. But anyway, Todesser is capping the center point. It's, I remember there's no HE shells as well. Too bad the Breda wasn't more closer to the right. It's actually shooting at the guys behind the sandbag here a lot. It's doing nothing. Tank crew going in to try cap. It's being out-capped by the conscript though. This Panzer H needs to stop the cap before it's too late. This has to happen now. 97. He needs to get there, run everything there possible. Oh no, what's this? The bazooka, 80 infantry. Boom, bounces, doesn't matter. But look, he needs to get the flag right now. Running the SMGs. Oh, dude. Oh, there's not much to control. How did he lapse this one? And it's capped, and you know what that means. I think it's a good game. It's not going to be able to be capped back. That Panzer H could have mowed everything down. Chino wasted this opportunity. And I think there it is. Todesser progresses to the grand finals to meet the winner of Sausages and Hansy, which should also be an epic game. I think any player who makes it to the grand finals, Sausage or Hansy, will have a pretty close game with Todesser. Should be an epic one. Yep, good game, guys. Well done to Todesser. Bad luck to Chino, showing a lot of promise in this tournament, but just not making it.